All right, welcome back. I'm Paul for rgames.com, owrgames.com. I'm playing through The Walking Dead, and last time I played through episode 3. This time I'm going to go and finish episode 4. Around every corner. So we just picked up two new people, Omid and the girl. Can't remember her name. She seems pretty wary of us. He seems, I don't know. I haven't really gotten a good vibe of him yet. But, yeah. We'll see what happens in this episode. What is it?
Previously on The Walking Dead.
Shut up, Carly! I've heard enough out of you!
Now, what the fuck's the problem?
Just get in. We'll figure out what to do with you.
I was trying to protect all of us.
Holy shit! She's stealing the RV!
She stole the RV.
I don't know much
too.
About you, folks. But I can tell you as sure as the sun's gonna come up tomorrow. Y'all keep going on like this, and that girl ain't gonna make it.
What do we do? Give me the gun, kid. I'll do it. I think we should look for your parents.
Really?
Yeah, you need to know if they're okay, and, well, if they're not, what happened to them?
I was the one giving the bandits supplies.
What?
It's all my fault.
We got a job!
Came out.
What? No way!
Said that, which is crazy.
Ah! Shit!
Can't wait for you to get to Savannah, Clementine. I got your parents right here, and you be sure to find me, whether Lee wants you to or not. Now, what I need...
The fuck?
I don't know, but I doubt we're gonna be happy when we find out.
Yeah, so that was the big reveal. Was that there's a guy that's been talking to Clementine, telling her that her parents are alive and all that kind of stuff, so we're gonna have to figure out what's on that. So in case you can't tell, my TV's off to right. Yeah, Omid fucked up his leg in the last game. He's still pretty pissed. I didn't know this was written by Gary Whitta. It's cool. The League of Writers writing the new Star Trek Rogue movie. Ooh, he's pissed.
Just for a little while, we're getting real close to where my mom and dad are. Maybe I can...
Not now, Clementine. Maybe later, okay?
Okay.
How's Omid?
His leg's pretty bad.
I'm fine.
You're not fine. You need to rest. He needs to rest.
Kenny, how much farther to the riverfront?
There should be just a few more blocks up ahead.
And there'll be boats there?
It sure as hell better be.
There'll be boats. Have to be.
It's going to be okay. Kenny knows what he's doing.
What the hell?
Maybe this city's not so dead after all.
Keep moving. No one's ringing that bell. It's automatic. On a timer.
What kind of church bell goes off at 20 past the hour?
Uh-oh. This ain't good.
Someone's up there!
Are you sure?
I don't see anything.
I know what I saw. I'm telling you, there's someone up in that bell tower. Someone alive.
If I were you, I'd get out of the street now.
I thought you said that thing didn't work.
Who the hell is this? Hello? Hello! I said answer me!
Is that the same guy, though?
That's what I'm wondering. What was that? Is someone trying to fuck with us?
Sounded more like a warning.
Ask not for whom the bell tolls.
What are you yammering on about?
It tolls for thee.
It's feeding time.
Everybody, run!
Too close, don't you think?
Ben!
No! Ben, help her! God damn it!
Move your asses! River Street's right up ahead!
That's not all.
He came along in the last episode too, that old guy.
Oh, give me a fucking break!
Wait, where the hell's Chuck?
Shit, he's in trouble! We gotta help him!
There's no time! We gotta go, now!
I'll be fine!
Just go! I'll get the door.
You okay?
Yeah.
You've opened up your wound. You're bleeding. Shit, it's gonna get infected. We've gotta get him inside. Clean him up.
Kenny, how's that door coming?
I'm working on it, I'm working on it!
We'll work faster, would you? Won't be long before those things outside figure out where we went. You know they can smell blood.
Let me see if I can find us a way in. Just a doghouse. Looks like something was buried here. Able to bust through that. Only Em won't be able to bust through that. What's this? Looks like there's some kind of pet door here.
I tried it already. That's locked too.
Who the hell ever heard of a locked doggy door?
I have. My neighbor had one just like that. It's radio controlled. The dog wears a collar with a chip in it, so the door only opens when the dog gets close to it.
Well, shit. Every day's a school day.
All right, so where's the dog?
Zombie dog. Oh, God.
thirsty enough to drink that yet. Looks like something was buried here. Empty. Well, that would have been too easy. Looks like something was buried here.
Come on, I know there's a zombie dog.
How's he looking?
I'm all right.
You're not all right. You've reopened your wound, you're losing blood, and God only knows what might have gotten in there. It could be infected, it could be...
No offense, but you really need to work on your bedside manner.
She's just worried about you, man. Don't worry. We're gonna get you fixed up in no time. Just as soon as we're inside, okay?
Okay. Thanks, man.
Please go and help Kenny. We need to get him inside now.
I'm on it. Just sit tight.
Hey, I'm not going anywhere.
Do you think the dead people saw us come back here? Are they going to find us?
Try not to worry. Even if they saw us, they can't get in here.
We did. Why can't they?
We're a lot smarter than they are. They're just like dumb animals. They can't open doors.
He used to have a pet hamster. One night, he figured out how to open the door to his cage. And when we woke up, he'd eaten half a box of cookies.
I don't think this is quite the same, Clem.
Yeah, right. This time, we're the cookies.
Just stay away from the gate, and we'll see about getting this inside smart. The house.
That's pretty funny.
Shovel is never not useful.
Hey, be careful. Digging up dead things isn't what it used to be, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I hear you.
What's buried down there?
Nothing. Clem, go over and sit with Krista and Omi, okay?
But I want to...
Just do what I say, okay?
Oh, God, the smell.
Get it off.
Okay, that is not cool.
Are you okay?
She's the only one. The little girl's the only one that's fine.
Are you sure you're...
I said I'm fine, okay?
I wonder if she's pregnant. He's worried if it's morning sickness.
I don't need that anymore. I'm done digging up dead dogs for today.
He just said that a shovel's a useful thing to have. Now he doesn't want it anymore. That doesn't make any sense.
Here goes nothing.
Yes! God damn!
You see anything in there?
No. Looks like it's been empty a while.
Whatever you're gonna do, do it fast.
Okay, let me see if I can reach up in there.
Be careful, man.
It's no good. I can't get it.
Yeah, they're gonna have to send Clem.
I think I can...
Clem, are you okay? Say something! Good work, Clem. But don't go shooting off like that without asking first, okay?
I was just trying to help.
I know, and you did good. You just had me worried there for a minute.
Can we maybe have this conversation inside? My leg's starting to hurt like hell.
Looks okay from here. Everybody in.
So this is where this episode's probably going to take place. No food. That's not a good sign.
Sorry.
No, it's okay. I'm good. Feel better already just being off my feet. Thanks, babe.
So, when were you gonna tell us about the radio?
Tell you what?
That it's working. That there's someone else on the other end of that thing. You didn't think that might have been worth sharing with the rest of us?
I was gonna tell you. Kenny and I only found out yesterday.
So both of you were keeping it from the rest of us. Great.
Who gives a shit about the damn radio? I'm more worried about whoever it was out there ringing that bell and bringing the dead down on top of us. It's like they didn't want us to make it to the river.
What makes you think it's not the same person? Whoever was on the radio was close enough to see us in the street, and we didn't see anyone else other than the guy in the bell tower.
Because that doesn't make a lick of damn sense. Why would they bring out the dead like that and then try to warn us about it?
How much sense does anything make anymore? In case you haven't noticed, there's a lot of twisted folks out there these days. At least the dead don't play games with you.
We need to make sure Chuck is okay. Once it's quieted down outside, we'll all head towards the river. See if we can find him. Deal?
Suit yourselves, but I'm not gonna wait around too long for someone else to grab up those boats. That's our ticket out of here.
Kenny's got such a one-track mind.
Place seems secure, at least.
I'll feel better when we know that for sure. We need to check the whole house.
All right, fine. You and me will take the upstairs. Lee, you've got down here. Make sure you check every door, understand?
Okay.
Every door. Or Kenny's gonna be mad.
Is there anything I can do?
Thanks, I got it. Hang out with Krista and Omid until I get back, okay?
Lee, I'm sorry.
What for?
Going through the door like that without checking first? I guess that was pretty dumb, huh?
Just ask me first the next time you're gonna outsmart all the grown-ups, okay?
Okay.
That's cute. A cute little exchange.
I should finish checking the house before heading back outside. All empty. No power. Hope we never get desperate enough for food that this starts looking appetizing. I'm not that hungry. Besides, I need to finish checking the downstairs.
Now we got a name to the dog, Walter.
Must have stopped working a while ago. Probably not the best idea right now. I need to stay frosty. Looks expensive and heavy. Doubt any looters would be able to haul that thing too far.
How's it coming?
Hey, guys.
How's the house looking?
Not done searching the first floor yet, but so far, so good. How's that couch treating you, Omid? Leg feeling better yet?
I'm all right.
I feel you.
That was a tepid response.
What do you guys think about this plan of Kinney's?
The guy's losing it. Look, Lee, I know he's your friend and all, but you need to be careful. That man is on the edge, and I don't know if I want to be around when he goes over it.
Kinney's solid.
That's true.
He's just been through a lot, that's all.
I hope you're right. For all our sakes.
Finding this house was a hell of a stroke of luck.
I like it a lot better when we know for sure it's safe.
I'll make sure. But right now it feels like just the break we needed. Maybe our luck's starting to turn around.
I'd like to believe that. Really, I would.
Sit tight. I'll keep checking the first floor to make sure it's safe.
Thanks, Lee.
She seems to be warming up a little bit.
Holding up okay?
I hope this house is safe. Have you checked all the rooms to make sure?
No, but I'll take care of it. Nothing hiding in here. Not exactly my style. All clear in here. Just one more to check.
And what do you want to bet there's going to be something interesting in there?
Jesus!
What? What happened?
It's nothing. Just, nothing.
This
ain't got much. We should be okay here for a while. At least until it quiets down outside.
Good. Thanks.
Is he okay?
Yeah, for now. But I'm really worried his leg might have gotten infected. Don't suppose you turned up any meds while you were poking around?
Nah, just dog food. And there's some whiskey in the back.
I was just asking Clementine if she knows who the man on her radio is. It's okay, honey. You can tell us. Who is he? What does he want?
Go ahead, Clem. It's okay. You're not in any trouble.
It's just a friend. I don't think he wants to hurt us.
What has he been saying to you? What have you been saying to him?
I told him I was trying to find my parents and that they were in Savannah. He really seems nice. I think he wants to help me find them.
Clementine, honey, trust me, that's not what he wants. He...
Lee? Lee, you need to get up here now.
What's wrong?
It's Kenny. Kenny said he thought he heard something up there. Went to go look.
He's up there?
I can't get him to come down.
Stay here.
Uh-oh. Something.
Kenny? Kenny, you okay, man? Oh, Jesus. What the hell is that? Oh, my God.
Looks like Duck, don't he?
It's just a kid. What the hell happened to him?
Ain't nothing on him. Guess he must have been hiding out up here. Starved to death.
Jesus Christ.
I don't know if I can, Lee. Couldn't do it before. Can't do it now.
Kenny, man, we don't have to do this right now. Maybe we should just get out of here. He can't hurt anyone.
You want to just walk away? I don't know if I can do that either.
Poor kid. Must have tried to hide out up here until he starved to death. Oh, this could have been Clementine if I hadn't found her when I did. All empty. He probably died of dehydration before he starved. Damn. Just ran out of food, like we almost did. Like we still might. What a way to live. What a way to die. Here. This'll make it clean and quick.
I don't know that I can do it, Lee.
I know that you can.
I couldn't even help my own boy.
That was your own flesh and blood. No father could have done that. But you can help this boy. Do what's right for him. Send him on his way.
It's kind of grim. But I think it did help Kenny.
We should bury him.
I'll take care of it.
Should have gotten the gun back from him. Kenny don't look like he's wanting to stay in this world much longer.
from us!
Lee, what's going on?
I saw someone standing there by the fence, watching us.
A walker?
No, too fast. Took off like a bat out of hell when I spotted him.
Was it a man or a woman?
Didn't get a good enough look.
What does it matter?
I'm wondering if it's the same guy who's been following us. The guy on the radio.
Kenny?
I'm fine. I'm fine. What's all the ruckus?
Lee saw someone watching us from outside the gate.
What? Who?
I can't be sure. It ran off before I could get a good look.
I don't like this one bit. Not one bit.
Me either. Walkers are one thing, but the thought of someone out there actually stalking us.
All right, that's it. We've stuck around here long enough. It's time to get back on track. Time to get down to the river and find ourselves a boat.
I don't know if Omid's well enough to move yet.
Well, he better get ready, because I'm going down to River Street right now to find a boat. And as soon as she's ready to go, we're moving out.
We only checked the house to make sure it's secure. We didn't really toss the place. We're low on food, water, meds, ammo. We should make sure there's nothing here we can use before we move out.
Well, you search it if you wanna. I'm done with this house. We came to this city to find a boat, and that's just what I'm gonna do.
Maybe it's not such a bad idea to check the place
I said I'm done with this house!
Yeah, Kenny's going off.
We can do both. Ben, you take one last look around the place. Grab anything that looks useful, while me and Kenny go down to the river to get us a boat.
Wait, can't I come? My mom and dad can't be far now. Maybe we can look for them on the way to the river.
Clem, honey, I think it'd be best if you stayed here with Ben. I need you to watch out for Omid and Krista. Help them get ready to move out.
You said I'm supposed to always stay close to you.
I know, it's just this once. Sometimes we all have to put aside what we want for the good of the group. Hey, don't worry. I'll be back before you know it, okay?
Okay.
Daylight's burning. Gonna go grab my gear, then we'll head out.
Come on, Clem. Let's go see if Omid needs anything.
So, you're just gonna leave me on the bench here?
That's not how it is, Ben. I need you to stay here and keep an eye on Clementine.
I can do that.
Well, just so we're clear. While I'm gone, anything or anyone tries to get inside this house, you shoot them. Don't even think twice about it. Understand?
I got no problem shooting walkers.
Did you hear what I said? Anything or anyone? Good.
I don't think this is a good idea to leave them. Something's definitely gonna happen here. This isn't good.
Your eye out for Chuck. He might be waiting for us around here.
Yeah, sure. Son of a bitch! That bastard's fucking with us again! It's another trap!
No, listen. That's not the same bell as before. This one's further off. Whatever it is, it's gonna get the dead moving over there.
What in the hell is going on?
I have have no idea. Someone must be ready for those bells.
Whatever, man. I find whoever's doing that, I'll ring their motherfucking bell for them.
Good one.
Let's keep moving.
Do these zombies move in herds? It looks like they're herding animals.
Still nothing moving behind us. I think we're... Oh my god.
There's gotta be a boat. There's gotta be.
Kenny man, let's just go back to the house and tell the others. Come up with a new plan.
This is the plan! It's the only one we've got, and you pissing on it in front of everyone like you did back at the house ain't exactly helping. Screw you. I ain't giving up that easy. This one might still be salvageable.
Seriously?
You got a better fucking idea? I'll check it out. You look further along the waterfront. Maybe there's something at the other end.
I don't think we should split up too far.
We don't have to. See that telescope? You can see all the way along the waterfront from right here. See what you can find.
Okay.
Isn't he gonna need a quarter? Oh my god, there's like a fucking wall of dead.
Great. Needs a quarter to work. Some kind of warning? Don't do something like this. These markings, they're all over the place. Could be military tags, but what do they mean? Hello, beautiful. Empty. Yeah, it would have been too easy. Siphoned, tires removed, engine parts missing. Looks like this thing has been stripped clean. Must have been a hell of a wreck. Been trying to back their boat into the water. Only things didn't go as planned. You got a quarter on you?
Don't have a lot of use for small change these days. Maybe you can find one on the street somewhere.
I should probably stick close to Kenny. It's too dangerous out here.
Where's this damn quarter?
What's up with the boat?
It ain't gonna work. Hull's cracked beneath the waterline, plus someone stripped out the battery.
You can't fix it?
What the hell is that?
A fate worse than death. No sign of any boats down there. No way that one's salvageable. What the hell? Get down!
Why the hell are we hiding?
Someone came down from that building at the end of the street.
Where'd he go?
Saw him run into that newsstand.
Could be our bell ringer. How about we go find out? Yeah, well, it seems to have a way of finding us anyways. Look, this could be the guy from the radio. The one who's been messing with us. If he is, we can put an end to it. Right now. Okay, you head up the middle of the street. I'll go around the side, cover your flank. We'll come up on him quiet, take him by surprise.
We just want to talk to this guy.
Oh, we're gonna talk.
You're not from Crawford.
Crawford? What the hell are you talking about? Kenny, don't! No, he's with us!
Now they're coming.
Who the hell are you people?
I ask you first.
The name's Molly.
Molly? I'm Lee. This is Kenny and Clementine. We're not looking for any trouble.
Hi.
You guys really aren't from Crawford, are you?
No. I'm from Macon. Kenny here's from Florida.
She didn't ask for our life stories, Lee. What's the deal with this Crawford place?
You sure you want to know? When everything started going to shit, some people got together and sealed off that whole neighborhood. Folks willing to do anything to stay alive. Stop the dead getting in. I try to avoid them.
Why?
Let's just say they have a zero-tolerance policy for anyone who won't or can't live by their rules.
So how'd you know we weren't them?
Because there are no children in Crawford. Not anymore.
Do you know who's been ringing those bells all over town?
Yeah, that would be me.
I knew it! Lee, I knew she was the one who'd been following us! Fucking with us!
Get that finger out of my face, Grandpa, before I jam it straight up your ass. I haven't been following you. I don't even know who the hell you people are.
Calm down, Kenny. The voice on the radio was a guy, remember?
Yeah, well, whoever you are, ringing those bells this morning nearly got us all killed. Raise the dead all around us.
That's the idea, genius. It's how I get around. I ring a bell in one neighborhood to attract the local geeks towards it. Buys me some time to scavenge the areas they cleared out.
Geeks? Is that what you call them?
Yeah, you know, like at the carnival, they'll eat anything, alive or dead.
That's pretty smart, the bells.
Doesn't take much to outsmart the dead. Bunch of dumbasses. You just gotta move fast. Get in and out before they start to wander back again.
What do you mean, no children? Why not?
No children, no elderly, no one with an advanced medical condition. Basically, no one who might be a burden on the community. Crawford's all about the survival of the fittest. That's how they survived, while the rest of the world went to shit around them.
Jesus Christ.
Well, just the opposite, when you think about it.
What exactly did Crawford do with all these burdens? What happened to them?
Well, you met some of them already.
Fuck me.
Yeah. Anyone who got sick, anyone too old, anyone they figured wasn't strong enough to survive. To them, those people were just mouths to feed, a drain on their precious resources.
Well, obviously this would happen.
Everyone in Savannah knew. What was going on inside Crawford got passed around like a ghost story. Except this one was true. Look, I'm gonna ask you people again. You're not from Crawford, so who the hell are you? What are you doing here?
Came down here looking for a boat, hoping to get our people out of here and find someplace safe.
Yeah, good luck with that. Anyone with a boat took it out of here as soon as people started eating each other. Any that got left behind, Crawford stripped them for parts. Cars, too.
There's gotta be something.
If there was, do you think I'd still be here? I've been over every inch of this city. This whole place is picked clean.
God damn it! Fuck!
Hey, moron. You want to keep your voice down?
Shit.
Since you're not getting on any boat, I'd advise you folks to go back to where you came from before... Great. Just great.
Isn't that the...
The way we came.
Fuck. gunshot must have brought him back.
Isn't there another way back to the house?
Mom, is there a...
Just gonna let her go? Hey! You can't just leave us here!
Really? Watch!
No! Please! Please don't leave us!
Come on! Make it fast!
Oh, fuck me!
Come on! Come on! Hurry!
Come on!
Come on, man! One good jump!
No! Pete! Hurry!
Come on, Lee! Get your ass out of there!
Here, use that to pry it open.
That was close. Got my heart racing.
Clementine, can you hear me? If you can hear me, just get back to the house, okay? I'll meet you there.
Like this is where the handle would go, but it's not here. Don't turn anymore in that direction. Good.
thing I'm out here, and not in there. Seems loose. Shit.
Chuck.
He must have tried to hide out down here. Poor bastard. No bullets. He must have saved the last one for himself. You deserve better, old man. It's enough to keep people alive for months. Wonder if someone's living down here.
Who are you?
Guess we found Crawford.
It's all right. It's okay. I don't want any trouble.
Neither do we. Which is why you'd do well to turn around and leave right now.
Look, I'm sorry I disturbed you folks. I'll just be going.
You can't let him leave. He's from Crawford. If he goes back there and they find out we're down here...
Are you from Crawford? They don't lie to me. I'll know.
Where else can he be from? Everywhere else around here is dead.
I'm not from around here. I'm from Athens. Grew up in Macon.
I have a brother in Macon. You were there? How was it? As bad as here?
I'm sorry.
You can't trust him, Vernon. You can't let him leave.
What do you want me to do? Shoot him in the head?
Why not? Be more of a mercy than anyone from Crawford ever showed us. Think, Vernon. What do you think they'll do if they find out we're down here, right under their feet?
Damn it. You're right. I'm sorry, friend. Can't take the risk.
I'm not from Crawford, but I saw what they did up there. It made me sick. I'm not like them, and I don't think you are either. I think you're a good man.
Keep back, or I swear I'll shoot.
It's all right. It's okay.
Vernon, what the hell are you doing? Vernon!
Relax. I'm not here to hurt you.
You're really not from Crawford?
No, I'm really not.
Well, we are, or were. We got out of there when they started sealing up the place. You know, started weeding out the sick and the old so the perfect survivor society wouldn't be threatened. No room for weakness or vulnerability in their little master race.
You don't look that old, so you're sick?
We're sick. We're all members of a cancer survivors group that used to meet here at the hospital. We're in remission. But that wasn't good enough for Crawford. They'd already rounded up five of us before the rest of us managed to hole up and hide from them down here. This old basement's been abandoned for years.
What is this? A morgue?
Yeah. Irony's always high on my list when I'm looking for a place to survive. How did you find your way down here?
My group and I were up by the river looking for a boat. Now I just want to get out of here and find them again.
Well, that sewer system you came through runs all over the city. It'll take you wherever you want to go.
Thanks. I think I can figure out my own way back.
Vern, you're not just gonna let him go back out there alone, are you? Those sewers are like a maze. He's got no chance of finding his way back without a guide.
You're not gonna be able to get out of here on your own, but we all got our own problems. Two of our group are sick and need constant care, and I'm the only doctor here.
Besides, why should we help you?
Look, sorry if I scared you. I just want to get back to my people. Back to Clementine.
She's your daughter?
No. She lost her real parents. I'm doing what I can.
You're not seriously considering going with him.
It's all right, Bree. I had a daughter, too. Lost her in the first days. I'll be damned if I'll just sit back and let that happen to someone else.
We need you here.
Don't worry. I'll be back before you know it. Let's go.
Why is it so shaky?
Clementine? Clem? Molly?
Oh, hey, you made it back.
Who's this?
He didn't tell you about me? Understandable, I guess. I'm the one who put that beating on him when he tried to jump me back at the river. Who's the fossil?
Where's Clementine?
She's around here somewhere. Relax. I got her and Kenny both back safely. You're welcome, by the way. I think you have something that belongs to me.
Lee, thank God you're back.
Krista, what's wrong?
It's Omid. He's gotten worse. Much worse.
We have a man wounded.
Who's this?
This is Vernon,
He's a doctor.
Oh, thank God.
Could you take a look at him?
You have to help us. Please.
I'll see what I can do. Take me to him.
Guy's got a really distinctive voice. I think I've heard it before.
Omid, honey. You're gonna be all right. Lee brought a doctor.
All right, let's take a look at him. I work better without an audience. I'm sure you have more things of your own to attend to.
Clementine. Clementine? Clementine, you here? Clem? Hello? What are you doing?
Just poking around.
You won't find anything. We already searched the place.
You'd be surprised what people miss. Trust me, I've been doing this for a while.
Where's Clementine?
Don't ask me, I'm not her keeper.
Hey, do I look like I'm in the mood to be jerked around? Where did she go?
Last I saw, she was downstairs with your redneck friend and that college kid who hangs around with him. Why don't you go bug them?
See her out there. Clem? Clementine? Clementine, you in here? Where is she? Clementine? Drawings, but where is she? Clementine, come out, please. Kenny?
Oh, hey, you made it back. Good job. Good job.
What the hell do you think you're doing?
What does it look like?
Where'd you get the bottle?
Found it. You want to throw down again like back on the train? Because I fight better when I'm shit-faced.
Kenny, come on, give me that. Kenny, give me the damn bottle.
Get the fuck away from me.
Getting wasted's not gonna help anyone.
Yeah? Well, what is? We are fucked! Molly said there's not a single boat left in Savannah. No way out. We got walkers all around us, that crazy fuck on the radio messing with us. Hell, if now ain't the time for a drink?
Have either of you seen Clementine?
Damned if I know. Gotta be around here somewhere.
Ben, I gave you one job when I left here. Take care of Clementine. Then she shows up out on River Street looking for me. What the hell happened?
Hey, don't put all that on me. Omid took a turn for the worse, and Krista asked me to help. I'm sorry, I'm doing the best I can here. She was frantic and things got kinda crazy. I told Clementine to stay put. What else could I do?
Don't be sorry. Just tell me where the hell she is now.
I think she went out to play in the backyard.
On her own? With no one watching her?
Man, will you get off my back? She's fine out there.
She better be, or it's your ass. Clementine? Clementine!
Door's covered in vines. Don't think anyone came in through there. What are you doing in there?
Exploring. And look! Look what I found!
This was here the whole time?
I know, right?
Kenny's gonna want to go right away. Lee's gonna want to prepare. It's gonna turn into a fight. I don't know how this old guy's gonna have fit into all of it, but...
Omid's doing okay?
As well as can be expected under the circumstances. I did what I could for him. Cleaned out the wound. He's got a real infection. Running a fever. Without antibiotics, I...
Will you quit pacing? You're making everyone nervous.
Why are you even still here?
Hey, if your friend really can get that boat working, you're taking me with you as payment for saving your asses. I figure that's fair enough, don't you?
Well?
You want the good news or the bad news?
I think we could all use some good news.
Good news is, the boat's seaworthy enough. In pretty good shape, mostly.
Mostly?
That's the bad news. Gas tank's empty, and her battery's dead. We need to fix both before she's taken us anyplace.
Well, how are we supposed to get that stuff?
We should go back out on the street, see what we can find.
That's not gonna work. Crawford took everything and brought it inside their walls. They siphoned every gas tank, stripped every battery. There's nothing left out there. You saw that for yourselves.
She's right.
Well, what about this Crawford place? Sounds like they'd have everything we need. Maybe we should try there.
Now hold on a minute.
Surely we have to try. If there are people left in this city who are still alive, who still have supplies, what harm can it do to ask?
Trust me, you don't know these people. I do. You showing up with a wounded man? Might as well put a noose around his neck. They don't exactly welcome children with open arms either.
What the hell kind of a place are we talking about here?
The worst kind? But I don't see what other choice we have.
And just how exactly do you figure we do this? Because from what I've heard, that place ain't exactly friendly to outsiders.
There's got to be some way we can sneak in there undetected.
There might actually be a way. I know the sewer system that runs beneath Crawford like the back of my hand. Y'all wouldn't happen to have a map by any chance?
Yeah, actually.
I think I could lead us through so we could pass under the perimeter and right into the center where they keep their supplies. We come up right underneath them, take them by surprise, grab what we need, and get out before they even knew what hit them.
That's actually not the worst idea I've ever heard. I mean, it's close, but I don't know. Maybe it could work.
I've thought about it before, just never had the people to do it. But I think if we all work together, we could pull it off.
And what do you want in return for all this help you're giving us?
Crawford doesn't just have what you need for your boat. They're also well stocked with medical supplies. Medicine that my people could use, just as yours could.
We can do this. We have to.
So, it's decided then? We're going to Crawford?
Anyone else have a problem with this plan? Because we're gonna need every one of us to pull this off.
Man, I don't know.
I don't know about you, kid, but I'd rather take a chance on doing something than just sitting around here waiting to die. That boat out there is an answered prayer. Just gotta push a little bit farther. Are you in or out?
We should go tonight, under cover of dark.
Man, that kid, it sucks.
Give you all a chance to prepare. I'll be back before midnight.
Be careful.
That's how I'm still alive.
I told you to stay in your room. How long have you been there?
Is it going to be dangerous?
Is what going to be dangerous?
Crawford.
I can't lie to you, Clem. Yeah, it's going to be dangerous. But it's the only way to get the things we need to make Omid better and get the boat working. That's why we have to do this. Do you understand?
I don't want anyone else to die.
Neither do I, Clem, but sometimes we have to take that kind of risk.
I guess I should go get ready.
Say what now?
You said you'd need all of us to do this, and you said I'm a big help, remember? Molly said Crawford is the only place left in Savannah that still has people. That means it must be where my mom and dad are, right?
Where I'm going, it's just too dangerous. For children especially.
You said I'm supposed to always stay close to you. Can't I come with you?
Okay, you can come. But you have to promise to stay quiet and do exactly what you're told the whole time we're there.
Okay. I'm gonna go get ready.
Uh-oh. I think it's better to take her with me, though. Keep an eye on her.
Check out what I found in the garage. Hatchet, hacksaw, some other tools. Might come in handy on this little break-in.
Nice.
Can I talk to you a minute?
What's up?
I took another look at the boat. She's a 30-footer.
So?
So, we're gonna have a capacity problem. Boat that size ain't gonna hold more than 5 people. Even with one of them a kid.
Me, you, Clem, Krista, Omi, Ben, Molly.
Assuming everyone makes it back alive, that's still one too many. Even if we cut Molly loose. Before this is over, we're gonna have to make a decision.
You're not serious.
Look, I'm just saying, if we want the best chance of... Who the hell is this?
This is Bree. She can help us.
Help us how?
I was a student at the school where Crawford keeps their supplies. I know the layout.
With her help, we're in it. Anyone have a problem with that?
I guess not.
Then what are we waiting for? Let's get moving.
Hold up just a sec. You ready?
Ready.
Hey, whoa, hold on a minute. You're not taking her with us. Did you not hear anything I said about the kind of place Crawford is? If you take her in there and they find her...
This little girl's not just excess baggage. She's gotten us out of a tight spot more than once. She's coming. Deal with it.
You heard the man. Let's move out.
So nobody's staying with Omid? The guy's just staying by himself. It's kind of weak. How much you want to bet he's gonna
This should be it. We're right underneath the center of Crawford. The old school should be directly above us.
Okay, people. This is it. Remember the plan. We stay quiet, we stay hidden, and we stay together. We find what we need, and we get the hell out before anyone even knows we're there. Got it? And that part about staying close, that goes double for you. Can't get a good look above with the cover on. Let's go.
Where is everybody? There should be guards patrolling.
What? You disappointed?
It's just strange, is all.
I think I see one. Over there by the door.
Okay. Me and Ginny will sneak up, try to take him out quiet. The rest of you wait for our signal.
Crawford has become zombie country.
Okay, Ginny, let's do this quiet. No shooting unless there's no other choice.
Right behind you.
What the fuck?
Yep. Crawford's
done. What the
fuck
is a walker doing inside here? Get inside, fast! Definitely.
What the hell happened here? I thought this place was supposed to be secure.
What always happens, I guess. In the end, the dead always win.
Oh man, we are so screwed.
No, this is good.
What? How the fuck is this good?
Before, everyone at Crawford was smart and they had guns. Now they're dumb and they don't. Hey, trying to look on the bright side here.
I agree. So long as we don't let them box us in, we can still do this. The plan hasn't changed.
The plan hasn't changed? Every time walkers show up, the plan changes. Do you even have any idea how many of them are out there?
No. You want to do a head count? Or do you want to get what we need and get the hell out of here? Come on. I think I know which way to head.
I got a bad feeling about this.
Just keep moving.
Here.
Looks okay. Everybody in.
You might want to leave one lookout, maybe. I don't know. Maybe that's just me. I like to stay safe, you know. Doesn't look like there's anything in there. No. Armor.
Figures.
Looks like they were using this room as some kind of command center.
Okay, so now what? Where do we start looking?
Here. Just give me a sec.
Where would be the best place to look for medicine?
Right here. Nurse's station. They were using it as a medical facility.
How do you know that?
Just makes sense, doesn't it?
Any idea where we could find a battery?
Maybe at the auto shop. There used to be one in the alley outside the fire escape.
Yep, it's called Herman's. You can't miss it.
What about the fuel? Where should I start looking?
There's a maintenance shed across from the playground here. If they were storing fuel, that's probably where it'll be.
Okay. I'll make the run to the maintenance shed for the fuel.
It'll be faster if I go with you. I can take you right to it.
I'll come too.
No, two people's enough. You stay here, see if you can use any of those tools we brought to get that armory door open. We might need to shoot our way out of here.
I'll go for the medicine.
I'll come with you. I know what to take.
Okay. Guess that leaves me to go find us a battery.
I'll go with you. Watch your back.
Okay, we've got a plan. Everyone be careful. Stay close to one another. We'll all meet back here.
Where's Clem?
What about me? What can I do?
I need you to stay here with Ben and watch over our command center. I'm putting you in charge of it, okay?
That's not
you're true. Leaving me with Ben?
I'm not leaving you with Ben. I'm leaving him with you. Understand?
Oh, okay.
Back before you know it.
Uh-oh. That's not gonna be good. Ben's got confidence issues as it is. Adding that onto it.
Nothing but crayons and construction paper. So according to Bree, fuel is at the maintenance shed, medicine might be at the nurse's office, and a battery would probably be at the auto shop out through here. Bree said the entrance to the auto shop was in the alleyway by this fire escape. Hey, you need any help with that?
Thanks, I got it. Just once, I'd like to do something useful, you know?
Well, I'll let you get on with it.
No, wait. There is something you can help me with. Something that's been on my mind. I could use your opinion.
What is it?
It's Kenny. Since I've been helping him work on the boat, I've gotten to know him a little better. He's a good guy, you know? And it's eating me up knowing what I know. I've been thinking about telling him the truth.
Ben, come on. This again?
It's my fault Duck and Katya got killed. If I hadn't screwed up back at the motor inn, they'd still be alive. How am I supposed to just carry something like that around?
I have to tell him.
Ben, no offense, but have you lost your motherfucking mind? Kenny's barely hanging on. You tell him you're to blame? I don't even want to think about what he might do.
I know. I've thought about that. But I don't know how much longer I can keep looking him in the eye. I feel like I'm lying to him by not telling
him. I'm telling you, man, it's a bad idea. Real, real bad.
Hey, maybe you're okay walking around with somebody's blood on your hands, but that's not who I am. I can't just pretend it never happened.
Damn, that's fucked up.
Look, we need Kenny. We need him to hold his shit together if we're ever gonna get out of here. So you need to keep this to yourself, for the good of everyone. You hear me?
I hear you. I'm gonna get back to this.
He's got me a problem.
The alleyway to the auto shop's down here. You coming or not?
Been fired. They're worthless. Must be the guy who ran this place. Looks like he figured himself as some kind of supreme leader. This must be the door to the alleyway where the auto shop is. But where the hell is Molly?
Oh, God.
Molly, you out here? Guess I'm not going that way. Auto shop must be down this way. Herman's. This is the place I'm looking for. Climbing the fence isn't an option. Thank you.
something to click on.
Damn, it's jammed tight. Better not get too close.
He's mine.
What were you doing up there? Molly? Molly!
What?
I think you got it.
One more!
He's wearing medical scrubs. Some kind of scientist or doctor, maybe?
Yeah, well, he ain't shit now. Did you find us a way in?
Yeah.
That was personal,
obviously.
The garage
door's jammed. Can't raise it.
Not a problem. Look what I found.
Oh, yeah. That'll work.
And it needs to work quickly.
Come on! Take a look around. I'll make sure no stragglers get under this door.
Well, I can see where the battery should be, but it's not.
Perfect.
No power. Looks like it's the hose for the lift hydraulics. Can't reach it up there. It's locked. No way in. More of Crawford's rules. How did anybody live like this? I'd rather take my chances on the outside. Don't think I can pry that hose apart with just my hands. Maybe if I had something to cut it with.
Something you need?
What was all that about back there?
He came at me up on that rooftop. Tried to take a bite out of me, so I took care of business. What, you got a problem with me killing geeks?
No. It just seemed like you went to town on him a little more than you needed to.
Hey, you never really know when those things are all the way dead. I was just making sure. Look, you want to get this battery or not? Time's wasting.
Think I can borrow that, hook thing of yours?
I don't know. Hilda and I have been through a lot together.
Hilda?
That's what I call her. Don't judge.
Please, can I borrow Hilda? I'll take good care of her. She won't get a scratch.
I got your promise now. Not a scratch. Something you need?
So why did you decide to help us?
I told you. I'm expecting a ride on that boat once that hillbilly friend of yours has got it running.
You sure that's all of it?
You want to keep interrogating me? Or do you want to get the damn battery and get out of here?
What do you think happened to Crawford?
Don't know, don't care. As far as I'm concerned, these fuckers got what was coming to them.
Not a lot of sympathy for all the people who died here, huh?
I have about as much for them as they did for the sick and the old and anyone else they didn't think was fit to belong in their little paradise. So yeah, fuck 'em.
I'm going to have a look around.
You do that.
I did it.
Whoa, whoa!
That's probably not good.
No shit!
I'll try to hold him off. Hurry!
There's the battery. Finally something goes right. Still attached to the terminals. It's off. The negative terminal's still screwed on. Got that one off. Got it.
Yeah, but we still got a problem here. Put it in here. I'll carry it. Okay, follow me. Move your ass.
Great, now what?
Skylark.
Okay, so now we're on a roof.
Do you ever stop complaining? Come on. Come on, what are you, chicken? Jump!
What did you call me? Well, now that you mention it.
On whatever. Something I gotta do first.
What?
Catch you later.
Wait, you've still got the battery?
Yeah, I think I'll hold on to it. Make sure you don't leave without me. See you back in class.
Molly! God damn it, what the hell is she doing?
That sucks.
Little help! Little help here!
Lee, do something!
hammer. I guess I just am not getting it quick enough. Or the axe.
Fuck! The doors won't close all the way!
Please do something!
We got it!
Break the door with something!
Damn well better.
There's so many of them.
You got the fuel.
Let's not start high-fiving each other just yet. Let's get the hell back to the classroom. Give us a hand with these fuel cans. They weigh a goddamn ton.
Kenny's not gonna like that she took off with the battery. I know that. That's gonna cause a stir.
You're back!
Yeah, and we made out pretty good, too.
Great work, Kenny.
How you doing with that door?
Not so good.
Here, let me give you a hand. Did you get that battery yet?
Yeah, Molly has it. She should be back here soon.
She'd better be.
Bree?
Hey, Lee. Thanks for all your help back there. I don't think we would have made it without you.
No problem. We're all on the same team. So you're a cancer survivor, like Vernon and the others.
Yeah, I was diagnosed when I was in college. Been getting treatment ever since. Just when I was starting to get better, when I thought there might be some hope, all this happened. Lost my whole family. I'm the only one who survived. Funny how things work out, huh?
Interesting.
How long have you known Vernon?
Couple of years. He ran our support group. He was really great, helping me come to terms with my disease. But how do you come to terms with something like this? With a place like Crawford? I don't know what I or the other survivors would have done without Vernon. He's the one who held us together, kept us alive.
What do you think about this whole Crawford situation?
I'd rather not talk about it. Too many awful memories. Even being back here gives me a bad feeling.
Even now, with everyone dead?
I got no sympathy for what happened to these people. They weeded out the sick and the old, even children, those least able to defend themselves so that they could save their own skins. Whatever happened here, however Crawford fell, I consider it poetic justice.
Damn, girl, that's cold.
It's how I feel. If you'd seen what I seen, you'd feel the same. I'm a little busy here, Lee. Maybe you should go get that battery or help with the medicine.
You okay, Clem?
Yeah. This desk is just like the ones we have in my school. I know it's weird, but I kind of miss it, being in school.
Me too. I used to be a teacher, remember? Tell you what, when we find ourselves a safe place, set up a little classroom, just you and me.
Will there be homework?
No homework.
Where's Molly?
She had to go run an errand. She'll be back soon.
I hope she's okay.
She'll be fine. She's pretty tough.
Do you think things will ever be normal again? Just like the way they were before?
Yeah. It may take a while, but yeah. I do. Don't you?
I hope so.
That's good. You hold on to that hope. It's the one thing none of this can take away. Looks like they had quite a system here. Crawford's final solution.
What do we still need?
We already got the fuel in the battery. Once we find some medicine, we'll be good to go.
So where's this battery you found?
Molly has it. She ran off to do something.
Well, she'd better bring it back here. I don't know why you trusted that girl with it. We hardly know her.
She saved your life, didn't she?
Yeah, but what has she done for me lately?
They wandered into the hallway after we got inside. I think they must have heard us rooting around in here. The whole place is infested. They're everywhere.
Calm down. I took care of them. What about the meds? Did we find what we need?
Yeah, that's our other problem. Take a look. Looks like they were keeping all the prescription meds in that safe, locked up tight.
There's no way we can bust it open?
Maybe with enough time, but I don't know how much of that we have. Be a hell of a lot quicker if we just knew the four-digit combination.
Well, I doubt they just wrote it down and left it here for us to find. We should just try busting it open. We don't have any other choice.
Okay, you get started. I'll take a look around, see if I can find anything useful. I'll have to take time to rest later, I think. What is this? A copy machine. Not that it matters with no power around here. Just a bunch of papers. No safe combination, though. Phones probably haven't worked in months. Looks like some kind of medical file. The way this camera's set up, it looks like it would have had a pretty good view of that keypad. I wonder if it caught someone punching it in. Empty. Figures.
The tape's gotta be around here somewhere. Keep looking.
Y'all already checked these drawers?
Yes, Lee. Nothing in there worth taking.
Damn sassy attitude.
Already cleaned out. Hey, Krista.
Yeah?
I hope I did the right thing bringing Clementine with us. This place isn't exactly safe.
Then why did you?
Because leaving her alone with Omi didn't seem any safer.
What's that supposed to mean?
No offense, Krista, but Omi's pretty sick. If he dies with Clementine alone in the house with
her... That is not gonna happen. Do you hear me? That is not going to happen. We're going to get these meds to Omi, and he's going to be fine. He's going to be fine!
You're right. I'm sorry. Are you feeling okay?
I'm fine. Why are you asking me that?
It's just that you've been looking a little pale the past couple of days.
You've been throwing up?
Oh, come on! You just dug up a rotting dog carcass! I'm surprised we weren't all throwing up. Lee, I'm fine. Quit worrying about me, okay? Worry about Omid. We've got to get him these meds.
Are you making any progress with the safe?
No. Without the combination, I don't know how we're gonna get this damn thing open. If we don't get back to Omid with some medicine soon...
It's okay. We'll figure it out.
Look, Lee. I just want to get back to Omid. Let me do my thing, all right?
Okay.
Do your thing, girl.
What's this on the floor?
It's a sonogram.
It's a sonogram, dumbass.
How's it coming?
Slow. Too slow. I'm worried that by the time we manage to get this thing open, it may be too late.
How much time do you think Omid has, Doc?
You want my medical opinion? The sooner we get him some strong antibiotics to start fighting that infection, the better. Let's just leave it at that, huh?
Molly helped me get the battery we needed.
That's great. One down. Where is she?
She took off. Had some kind of errand she needed to run.
Took off? With the battery?
Yeah. Don't worry. She'll be back.
I hope so. That girl doesn't really strike me as a team player. More the mercenary kind.
Hey, Doc. I just wanted to thank you for coming with us. And for all your help. I really appreciate it.
Don't mention it. It's times like these we've got to help each other the most, right? And we're no better than those Crawford sons of bitches.
I heard that. I'll go see if I can find something that'll help us get that safe open.
Good idea.
There's dried blood on this printout, and on the floor. Looks like a trail of it from the safe to the camera over there, then out the door. What the hell happened here? As some kind of supreme leader. Might come back for these later. Any reading material would be nice once we get on that boat. Hey,
I'm a little busy here, Lee. Maybe you should go get that battery or help with the medicine.
So according to Bree, fuel is at the maintenance shed. Medicine might be at the nurse's office. And a battery would probably be at the auto shop out through here.
Why would a sonogram be in a nurse's station at a school?
Krista.
I'm busy, Lee. Just let me work.
Nothing in here, I guess.
That'd be a first.
Vernon, Krista, come look at this.
This is day 82 since the outbreak. 1547. Dr. Logan in consultation with patient Anna Correa.
Why are you recording this?
Regulations. Oberson has ordered me to keep records of all medical examinations and consultations. I need you to brace yourself, Anna. The sonogram confirms that you're pregnant.
Oh God, oh God, oh God.
As you know, the rules are very clear. The termination is mandatory.
You don't have to tell them. Tell them it was just nausea. That you gave me something for it and it went away. This is my problem, not yours.
If Oberson finds out that I concealed evidence of a pregnancy, I'm sorry, but these are the rules. I'm gonna give you a sedative. It'll make the procedure easier on you.
I don't want the procedure! I want my baby! I can't do this! I can't do this!
Anna, you don't have a choice.
Damn, this is fucked up.
Now, if you like, you can take some time with this, but I need you to come back no later than tomorrow, or I'll have no choice but to inform Oberson myself. I'm sorry.
Damn it! We almost had it.
What the hell kind of place was this?
Like Molly said, the worst kind.
Lee, maybe there's another tape. We gotta keep looking.
I think I recognize that doctor. He was one of the walkers out in the alley by the auto shop.
Maybe you should search it. See what he's got on him.
In
this might be just what we need. And what's this? Looks like some kind of code. But Vernon said the safe combination was only 4 numbers. Shit, time to go.
Doesn't show him getting back. How do you think he got back?
Logan. This must have been his locker. Another tape. The safe combination has gotta be on one of these.
Alright, we got 2 tapes. Game's been going on for 2 hours. Should be.
One of them is dated October 10th.
That's the day after the first one we watched.
Put it in.
Have you made a decision?
I thought you said I didn't have a choice.
Well, technically you do. You can terminate the pregnancy or leave Crawford. Of course, that would be a death sentence for both you and your unborn child.
Maybe that's best. I stayed up all last night thinking about this. Why are we even trying to survive? To keep on living, if this is what it takes. If this is what it's turned us into.
I don't make the rules, Anna.
Doctor, I'm begging you. Please, help me.
Maybe one day, when things are different, you can try again. But for now, today, we have to do this. No. No. No.
Well, that's how the doctor died.
I think we know what happened to Crawford.
More importantly, we got the combination.
Krista, are you all right? What's wrong?
It's nothing. That was
just pregnant. Duh.
Watch. Don't worry about me. I'm fine.
All right. Let's get those meds and get the hell out of here.
We're in business. Antibiotics, morphine. We'll take as much of this as we can carry. Okay, I think we're good. This is more than enough for your people and mine. Let's go.
You know, I found a 3rd tape in the locker outside. Maybe there's something else on there.
We got the meds for Omid. That's all I care about.
We'll head back to the classroom. Don't take too long, Lee.
This is gonna be a reveal about Molly. See what this has got.
Listen, as fun as this was, I have to put a stop to this little arrangement. This is the last I can give you.
Why?
Oberson had someone down here yesterday taking inventory. He's really cracking down. I just can't risk it.
We had a deal.
Yes, we had a deal. We don't anymore.
My sister needs this medicine. Without it, she'll die, or she'll start showing symptoms and they'll take her away. I can't let that happen.
I'm sorry, Molly. I've done all I can, but I have to look out for myself here.
Yeah, that's the Crawford way, isn't it?
So that's why Molly hates Crawford.
Well, shit. Christ! Oh, you scared the shit out of me. Where the fuck have you been?
Sightseeing.
I'll take that battery down.
Oh, yeah. About that. I'm just kidding. Here you go.
What's that?
Nothing.
You lied to me.
What?
You said you'd never been here before, but that wasn't the truth, was it?
What? Who told you that?
I saw you on a security tape. You were having an affair with that doctor.
I didn't lie.
I asked you how you knew about Crawford. You said you just heard stories.
I said there were stories about Crawford. I never said that's how I knew about it. I never lied to you, and even if I did, so what? I don't owe you anything.
You saved my life twice, but you can't tell me the truth?
Are we really gonna do this now?
I guess that's up to you.
I used to live here with my sister. She was 14 years old. When the dead started walking and Crawford shut itself in, it seemed like a pretty good deal at first. We were safe. We had everything we needed to survive. Then the rules started coming down. No one who couldn't justify their place or their keep. No one who required special care. My sister was diabetic, and by Crawford's rules, that made her a liability. I kept it a secret. Kept her safe for as long as I could. But in the end, I couldn't protect her. That's when I got out. Crawford, they always talked about how their system worked. How anything was better than becoming one of them. But I saw what they'd already become. I just wish I could have seen it before it was too late. Before they came and took my sister away. This is all I have left of her. I didn't have time to take it before I got out of Crawford. I just wanted it, okay?
It's okay, Molly. I understand. She's pretty.
What the hell?
I think that's our cue to get the hell out of here.
Jesus!
Ben!
Sorry. I just got spooked by those bells, and then I heard someone coming.
What the fuck are you doing out here?
Kenny and I still can't get the door open to the armory. He sent me out to look for something we can use to bust it open. I found this.
Ben? Where did you get that?
I just found it. It was stuck in the door handle at the end of the hallway back there.
Oh no.
Shit!
It wasn't me!
Good going, kid. Nice shot.
Thanks.
What the fuck is going on?
They're coming.
Oh, shit.
That ought to hold. Ben sucks.
Sure, but now how do we get
Ben
out?
Sucks so much.
Through the armory. We can just get this damn door open. Come on, damn you!
This is my fault, all my fault.
What the hell's he babbling about?
Ben, we talked about this.
No, wait. I want to know what he meant. What do you mean this is all your fault?
Kenny, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry, man.
Kid, this ain't the best time. Whatever you did, save it for later.
Ben, shut the fuck up.
Fuck you, Lee. I can't do this anymore. It's been me all along, putting all of us in danger. Katja and Duck, it was all me. It was all me.
Wait a minute. What are you saying?
It was me who made the deal with the bandits at the Motor Inn, slipping them supplies. I thought maybe I could keep them off our backs. When it got discovered, that's when they attacked. And that's when Duck...
Kitty man, I agree with you. You should kick his ass. But now's not the time. We gotta
focus on getting out of here!
You little pissant! You're fucking dead, you hear me? Dead! My wife and child! You gotta both fucking kill!
Kenny, listen to me. You can warp his skinny little ass later, but right now we gotta go!
Nice group you got here.
Not the time, Molly.
If this asshole thinks he's getting on my boat after what he did, he's out of his motherfucking mind! You hear me, shitbird? You can stay behind and fucking rot!
You know Ben didn't mean any harm. He was just trying to help.
And I'm supposed to give a crap about his good intentions? The boat's not big enough for all of us. Somebody's gotta get left behind. Might as well be this piece of shit right here!
Well, I vote we leave him. I'm sorry, Ben. I know you mean well. But all I want to do is get back to Omid, and you put that at risk.
Wait, don't I get a vote?
Of course you do.
Ben's nice. He's my friend. We don't leave friends behind. That's my vote.
On second thought, I think I'm gonna abstain. Lee?
I've seen enough of Crawford to know that becoming like them is the beginning of the end. I vote Ben stays with us.
What about the rest of us? Don't we get a say?
Now can we go?
Damn right. Vernon, come on!
Oh, that sucks.
So much for the armory.
What's left of it?
A few rounds. That's it.
You didn't close that door behind us?
I couldn't. The lock was busted.
Great. Just fucking great. Come on. There's gotta be a way out down here.
Not gonna hold. Back upstairs!
Lee, look!
I needed to select my leg. Oh, it took me after I die. I thought zombies were into brains, not guts.
Ah!
It's all right, Clem. I'm fine. Any way out of here?
This leads to the roof. We might be able to find a way down from there.
You didn't come into town from the railroad, did you?
Yeah. Why?
Never mind. I can see the sewer where we came in from here. I think we can do this.
Well, what are we waiting for? Go! Go!
Why'd he say that about the railroad? What does that have to do with anything?
Ben, come on, let's go! Up. Come on, you can do it!
There's no time! You have to go! Now!
Quit fucking around, Ben! Come on!
Let go, damn it! Get Clem and the others out of here!
Lee.
Lee, we both know.
Let me go!
Oh, damn.
Krista? Everything okay?
Oh, me!
He's dead.
Hold on. Is he dead? Krista, don't! Stay back!
I never should have left you. I'm so sorry.
Krista, get away from him!
Hey. Back already?
We got you medicine.
Good. Feel like I could use some. You okay, kid? You look worse than I do.
We almost didn't make it out of there because of this asshole. Should have left him behind when we had the chance.
Guys, what the hell happened out there?
Let someone else tell you. I got work to do.
Okay, with a little luck, you should start feeling better pretty soon. I'll stay here for a few more hours to check on him. Let me know if you need anything.
Thanks, Doc.
Yes, thank you so much.
Damn, this has been going for 2.5 hours.
Maybe now's a good
time
for you and me to have a little talk in private.
Listen, man, about what happened to Bree.
Don't beat yourself up over it. There was nothing you could have done. You want to know the worst part?
What?
I don't feel much. I mean, I don't feel enough. Shouldn't I be broken up over what happened to her? That's how I was when I lost my daughter. When I lost my friends in those first few weeks. But now, it's like I just take something like this in stride. Like this is what our world is now, and we'd better just get used to it.
What did you want to talk to me about?
I know you care about Clementine. Anyone can see that. And I know you want what's best for her. But this plan of yours, putting everyone on a boat with no destination, do you really think that's her best chance of finding somewhere where she can be safe? Because I don't. So I want to make you an offer.
What kind of an offer?
I'll take her off your hands, take her back with me, to my people. We're well supplied, well hidden, and a lot of us have had kids of our own. And now Crawford's fallen, we got nothing left to fear from them. She'll be safe with us. Safer than she will be if she stays with you, I promise you. That's what you want for her, isn't it? To be safe?
You're coming at me with a lot here, Vernon. I need to think it over.
Of course, take your time, but I want you to think about some things. You're a good man, Lee. You've been protecting these people as best you can so far, and they look up to you. Rightly so. But it's different with a child. You might have brought her this far, but sooner or later she might ask you for more than you can give her. I'm sorry if that's hard to hear, but it's the truth.
I appreciate it, Vernon. Let me think about it, okay?
You do that.
Yeah, that's a lot to put on him.
Hey, going somewhere?
Yeah, I'm about to head out. I just wanted to say thanks for everything. It's been fun.
So that's it? After all we've been through, you're just gonna leave?
Yeah, I figured you don't owe me anything. I got what I wanted in Crawford, and I never did like the water.
Where will you go?
I don't know. I'll figure it out when I get there.
What do you want me to tell the others?
Tell them whatever you want. I'm not real big on goodbyes. Tell Clementine she's going to be okay. You've got a good one there. She reminds me of me.
Kenny's working on the boat.
I know.
What are we going to do after he fixes it? Where will we go?
I don't know. We'll figure it out. We always do. Clem, honey, what's wrong?
Is Ben going to be okay? He doesn't seem the same since he got back.
Ben's a good kid. I think he's just feeling guilty about some of the decisions he's made. He's gotten a feeling like he's a burden on the rest of us.
Before we leave tomorrow, will we have time to look for my parents?
I'd like to, Clem, but I don't think we'll have time. We really shouldn't stay here any longer. It's not safe.
Her what she wants to do instead of going out on this stupid boat.
Clementine?
Shit, she ran away.
Clementine?
No bueno.
Clementine? Clementine! Oh, God.
Thank you.
No. Fuck.
Lee? Lee? You out here? Lee?
Damn.
Are you crazy? What are you doing out here? It ain't safe.
Lee? Where's Clementine? She's not in her room.
Vernon ain't in the house either. What the hell is going on?
Whose blood is that?
It's mine.
Oh my God.
No way. No. No fucking way.
There's no time to worry about me. Clementine's gone.
There's no chance she just wandered off on her own?
No. No way.
Then who the hell took her?
I don't know. Last night, Vernon came to me and offered to take her with him. Said she'd be better off.
Son of a bitch. I knew we couldn't trust that fucker.
Wherever she is, I have to find her.
Okay. What do you need from us?
Clem may not have much time. We have a better chance of finding her if we all go together. Who's with me?
We're all responsible for Clementine. And in your condition, you may not make it to her in time. She needs our help. All of our help.
Damn right. We can't let you do this alone.
So that's settled then. We'll look for Clementine together.
Hell yeah. What are we waiting for?
Thanks, you guys. I appreciate it. Really.
Lee, man. You know I care about Clementine. And I am a Christian man. And I keep asking myself, if this was me, asking you for help? Asking you to put your life on the line? Would you be there for me? Because there have been plenty of times when you ain't been.
Kenny, man, I'm begging you here. I can't do this alone. I need your help, please.
Lee, I know you had my back when we first teamed up. You really looked out for me and mine. But ever since then, you've been looking out for yourself more often than your friends. I'm sorry. But you're on your own on this one.
What about you, Ben?
I don't know. Whatever you think is best.
I can't make that decision for you, Ben. You have to decide for yourself.
You've been good to me, Lee. Even when it's not been easy. Whatever I can do to help, you can count on me.
Okay, guys. We should go find Vernon. See if he took her. Let's head out.
I'll get the boat out onto the river. Figure I can wait there until you get back. Or at least until nightfall.
You're still gonna take me. Even Ben.
Yeah. We'll figure out what to do about that when the time comes.
Come on, guys. Let's go. Where the hell are they?
Looks like they got out of here in a hurry.
Vernon! Get out here! There doesn't have to be any trouble here. All I want is the girl. Give her back and nobody needs to get hurt.
Thank you.
Are you all right? Where are you? Vernon, you son of a bitch! Who is this?
It's not Vernon, if that's what you're thinking. And you should really watch your tone.
Clementine's fine, but if I were you, I'd choose my next words very carefully.
Episode. Well, that was a pretty good episode. Let's see where we did. Most people killed him. I revealed my boat bite like most other people. So, yeah, that was a good episode. There was a lot of twists and turns in that one. Yeah, some good decisions too. I'm excited to save Clementine in this last episode. Well, I guess there's the DLC episode after that as well. So, yeah, a lot of stuff went on in this. You know, I think we're all pretty convinced that what's her name is pregnant. It's nice that that girl, Molly, ended up leaving the group without anybody having to push her out or make final decisions or anything like that. I'm kind of surprised. I mean, it just all comes down to writing, but I'm surprised that Lee didn't ask Clementine, like, before what they should do. When he was on the train, he asked her what she wanted to do, and so... yeah, I think he should have done that, but, I mean, that's really just a story thing. Nothing too big. But, yeah, I think I'll probably try and stream Chapter 5 tomorrow, hopefully. I got a few things to do tomorrow, but I'll probably have a little bit of time to stream. So, yeah, come back tomorrow, and we'll finish up The Walking Dead Season 1. Thanks for joining me for episode 4. And... yeah, catch me at owrgames.com. You can catch me on Twitter at owrgames or SOPACHUCO13.